identical twins. On first sight, they appear to be perfect clones, but talk to them and the illusion falls apart. Why do identical twins look the same and yet act so differently? The answer to the first part lies in DNA, a pretty famous chemical these days. It contains the instructions required for the development and functioning of living organisms, which it stores as a code made up of a sequence of four bases, a bit like the alphabet. When we need to access this information, it is copied onto RNA and then ultimately encoded into proteins and other machinery required for life by a process known as gene expression.
Our complete DNA sequence is really long. So it is wrapped around four different pairs of proteins known as histones. And this sequence keeps on repeating like beads on a necklace to form a long fiber known as chromatin. And our DNA usually hangs around loosely in the nucleus of our cell until it's time to divide. Twins share all of their DNA. And because our physical features or phenotypes are heavily influenced by our genes or genotype, they largely end up looking the same. But why do twins act differently or sometimes even have different attributes like height?
Well, consider a spirit animal quiz. When you and I take the test, the underlying algorithm is going to be the same. But the result is going to differ because it depends on variables such as your lifestyle or your favorite food. Gene expression happens likewise. In the past, we thought that our genetic makeup dictated our development. But thanks to breakthroughs in epigenetics, we now know that our diet, our behaviors, and our environment work together with our genes to influence our development. But how?
Remember histones, the proteins our DNA wraps around? Well, those things do more than provide just structural support. They have these sort of tails that extend past the DNA, and when different chemicals bind to them, it affects how our genes are expressed. For instance, adding acetyl groups increases gene expression. DNA clings to histones because of their opposite charges, but when you add acetyl groups, it neutralizes the positive charge of the histone, making the gene more accessible to transcription machinery, which in turn increases gene expression.
Methyl groups even attach directly to DNA segments, decreasing their expression. These epigenetic marks, as we call them, sometimes last for decades, whereas others are easily reversible. This is why twins are different. They are shaped not only by nature, but also by nurture. It's also how cells differentiate themselves and why I don't have eyes growing out of my arm. We are starting to understand the why behind the saying, you are what you eat. And with epigenetic mechanisms playing important role in aging, memory formation, and even the development of some diseases like cancer, it is sure to witness many more breakthroughs in the future.